Did you know that fewer than 7% of all pilots in the United States are women? Thankfully, that number is steadily rising. Aviation isn't just a man's world, and in today's video, we'll be learning about the top 10 women who changed aviation history forever. We'll also be discussing organizations dedicated to increasing the presence of women in the industry. Make sure you like this video and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy's YouTube channel for more aviation content. Also, visit epicflightacademy.com to learn how you can become a pilot or aircraft mechanic today. When people hear the phrase women in aviation, they inevitably think of Amelia Earhart, the famed aviatrix who, in May of 1932, was the first female to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean. However, Earhart was most remembered for disappearing on a 1937 flight across the Pacific Ocean, where she was just 39 years old. Earhart's disappearance has been a staple of mystery stories with dozens of theories about her fate. In March of 2017, forensic examination of bones discovered on a remote Pacific island 80 years ago strongly indicates they may have belonged to Amelia Earhart. The remains uncovered on Nikumaroro in 1940 were initially dismissed as being Earhart's because they were believed to have been from a man. However, a scientist used modern forensic software to analyze the measurements of the bones, comparing them to estimates of Earhart's bone lengths based on her clothing and photographs. The study revealed that not only are the bones female, but they also match Earhart's bone structure better than 99% of other people. Sadly, the actual bones have been lost over time, meaning further analysis, including DNA testing, may never be conducted. Whether this clears up or adds to the mystery, it's the kind of story people will likely debate for years. Regardless, Earhart's legend endures. She has served as an inspiration for female pilots for the better part of a century. The first woman to fly solo was Jeanne Labrosse, who piloted a hot air balloon in 1799. She was also the first woman to parachute from a balloon, descending in a gondola carried by a parachute. All this because she witnessed André Jacques Garneron's first hydrogen balloon flight and parachute descent in Paris on October 22, 1797. She became his student, made history, then married him and continued making her mark in aviation. Since then, women have been embracing aviation with enthusiasm, whether as a hobby or career. E. Lilian Todd's application to become a pilot was denied. This didn't stop her from reaching for the skies. In 1906, E. Lilian Todd was designing and building aircraft. This female inventor is certainly a hallowed name in the halls of aviation. France's Raymonde De Laroche became the world's first licensed female pilot in 1910. The Aero Club de France awarded her the 36th Aeroplane Pilot's License on March 8, 1910. On November 25, 1913, the Aero Club awarded her the Femina Cup for a long-distance non-stop flight that lasted more than 4 hours. Also in 1910, Belgium's Hélène Dutrieu became the first female pilot to fly with a passenger on April 19th. She had already achieved success as a cyclist, stuntwoman, and actress. She was known as the Girl Hawk at air shows for her aviation prowess. Bessie Coleman became the first African-American woman to become a licensed pilot in 1921. Bessie was biracial, so she was also the first Native American woman to hold a pilot's license. The Fédération Aéronautique Internationale awarded Bessie her license on June 15, 1921. Bessie was a media sensation in the US and remains a hugely inspirational figure in aviation today. So much so, in fact, that we have a classroom named after Coleman at our New Smyrna Beach campus. Helen Richey became the first woman to fly for an American commercial airline in 1934, but her aviation resume is much more extensive than that alone. She flew with the WASPs, who we will get to shortly, and once teamed up with Amelia Earhart, coming in fifth place in a transcontinental air race. Richey was sworn in as the first female pilot to fly airmail, and was one of the country's first female flight instructors. Her story continues to inspire female pilots, such as Epic graduate Elissa Figaro, who became the first female pilot and first female captain at Caicos Express Airways. In 1943, 1,074 American women took to the skies as women Air Force service pilots to do their part during World War II. They logged more than 60 million miles in flight as they ferried aircraft across the United States. These women were trailblazers and deserve recognition for their heroic acts during wartime. In 1978, Sally Ride became the first female astronaut in the United States when she joined NASA. On June 18, 1983, she made history as the first American woman to fly in space, launching from Kennedy Space Center aboard the Space Shuttle Challenger. She was the third woman to fly in space after two female Russian cosmonauts, Valentina Tereshkova in 1963 and Svetlana Savitskaya in 1982. As the 20th century drew to a close, Eileen Collins became the first woman to command a U.S. flight shuttle. Collins began as a flight instructor and test pilot, but the sky was the limit as she went on to be the first female to command a shuttle mission for NASA. We would be remiss if we didn't acknowledge Epic's own beloved Captain Judy Rice. Captain Judy, as she was known, circumnavigated the globe in a Citation Mustang. She visited 10,000 students in 24 countries as an ambassador for aviation. During this flight, she also set a world speed record from Greenland to Iceland. Captain Judy wrote the foreword for an inspiring book, 101 Trailblazing Women of Air and Space, Aviators and Astronauts, as well as her own memoir, Around the World with Captain Judy Rice. In addition to these extraordinary women in aviation, there are also organizations dedicated to ensure women continue to thrive in aviation. Hundreds of female pioneers rushed to enter the aviation industry, from daredevil stunt flying to military service. In 1929, 99 women pilots formed the first organization to support the advancement of females in aviation. They called themselves the 99s, in honor of the number of charter members. In 1990, Women in Aviation International was launched. This important organization also supports women training for careers in aviation, offering scholarships and other types of support. Both of these organizations are dedicated to encouraging women to take up flying, either as an avocation or career. In fact, in March 2018, the Institute of Women of Aviation Worldwide Week welcomed 61,000 women to its annual conference. During the first week of March that year, more than 12,000 women around the world took their very first flight. While women comprise just under 7% of pilots, fewer than 3% of aircraft mechanics are women. The great part is, these numbers continue to grow. If you're considering a career in aviation, Epic Flight Academy is a great place to start. Epic is proud to welcome female students pursuing aviation as a career. We hope this video inspired you to take off into a career among the clouds. Be sure to like this video before you go and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy so you don't miss any more aviation content.